kind of got in trouble the other couple months ago. I got in trouble, you know, because I kind of went crazy on French Montana.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I went crazy on French Montana, so Joe didn't like it, you know, because in all fairness, Joe's like, please, Pete, you know, that shit, you know, it's not the right thing to do, which we just actually finally talked about it after like months. I finally talked to Joe about it. And French Montana interviewed me before.
Yeah.
I used to be on a cocaine, whatever.
The cocaine
DVDs, on DVDs and all. Yeah. I used to be in all that shit. So he's my little man from down the block. I live on Cypress. He lives down the block. He lives down the block. He's my little man. He interviewed me for that shit. I took him up the block, showed him, you know, this is the where people try to kill me or that. You know, people jumped out with masks at. You know, people try to kill me before. I mean, I'm just not Pistol Pete and bust my gun anywhere I go.
Sure.
I mean, I get tried on too.
Yeah.
So, you know, and went through the whole interview and all that. You know, and but besides that, he's my little man. You know, he used to be scared for years, running around, scared, Macho Joe gonna smack me, you know, because I kind of fuck with Faithy and all this. He used to be, he's a paranoid, scared guy for years. So, and I was always his friend. You know, he's my little man. You know, Florida, he's calling me. He got all this fucking, tons of fucking fake jury and all that. Yo, P, I'm over here drunk. Could you please take me to the hotel? Yo, let's go get this fucking guy. Just go pick him up, bring him to the hotel, make sure tuck him in. You good? Okay, have a great night, buddy.
He said tuck him in.
You know what I'm saying? I'm saying for real.
And I know.
And then, now I can't get a hold of you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Now I can't speak to you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I know it's a lot of politics. You know, and I know a lot of people, you know, and I don't, we're going to probably save it. So when it gets better, you know, the dog in the yard, for anything else that, but, you know, the truth is, you know, a lot of people in that camp don't really appreciate, don't really like me.
Yeah.
So you know how that goes. It comes with the change. You know what I'm saying? It comes with the change. You know, so I got a little bit, I guess. I don't know. I was just like on Instagram, like, you know, they go suck my dick, you know, and French Montana is a fucking punk and the whole Bad Boys are gay, and I went nuts. You know what I'm saying?
So things
so
slowed down.
I probably should have never, you know, went out like that. I should have just kept it at French rather than, you know.
Sure.
When you say, you know, everybody else, the whole back, you know, we talking about people that it might be cool with me, D-Rock. You know, I'm just disappointed that somebody that used to scream at me for help all the time, you know what I'm saying? And now I can't. He did a song and a video with me for one of my artists a few years back when he popped off, and he's been gone since. So I'm just trying to reach out to him. That's all. I mean, we was able to talk to each other before. I don't see why we can't talk no more.
Sure.
So that was just it. That's just it. You know what I'm saying? And I don't appreciate that shit because I like to get a hold of motherfuckers. If I call you, trust me, it's about something. If I, you know, it's not just to say, hey, how are you? Where you at? Where you at? Performing and where? Oh, shit, I'm going to be there right in the front waiting for you. Fuck no. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not, it's not that kind of shit. You know what I'm saying?